I grew up in Los Angeles, and when I came to Nashville, I was really surprised at how they ran sessions. You know, it was very regimented and they had blocks of time. I find that sometimes that's geared more towards making a product and producing stuff. So it's been kind of interesting to kind of introduce a West Coast spin into that a little bit. I love the sense of community in Nashville. It's incredible. People really value the human aspect of living and of life, and it manifests itself in all kinds of ways in the artist community. So that's really exciting to be able to feel that here. I am such a huge fan of country records from the late 50s and the 60s. To me, that is the sound of Nashville. It's this beautiful, warm, gorgeous recordings that were made in real time with real people in a room all together. I think some of my strengths as a producer and a musician is that I have a idea in my mind about how I want certain sounds to sound, and I use that as like a starting point. I kind of like to feel like when I make music with people that my studio here, Resistor, it's like an art materials shop, and an artist can come in and there's all kinds of different things that they can pick, an instrument here or there, or a picture to look at, or a book to pick up, because I find that the best art is made when somebody is following their instincts.
Does it sound better than the deluxe?
That sounds great. It has a little bit more focus in the bottom.
Okay, cool.
My name is Brandy Zidane. I am a singer-songwriter, originally from Canada, but I am based in Nashville, Tennessee. My pre-session regimen is treating myself like an old lady, going to bed at, 8 p.m. the day before if I can, not doing anything debaucherous a couple nights before. Of course, lots of singing and warming up, making sure that I feel 110%.
Take you for miles. Verb up a little bit.
Yeah, sweet. A little spring reverb.
Yeah, beautiful. Are you the night rider? Are you the truth teller?
I always ask the engineer producer to put in a fair amount of verb. I'm not a huge fan of hearing my voice dry, that's for sure. I've known Josh for many years. We met, I think it might have been 5 or 6 years ago, and we've been in similar circles. We have tons of mutual musician friends, and over the years, when I've worked with producers, they always end up calling me in to do backups, and I get to sing on incredible artists' work.
I could hear doing away with this part right here, just right into the next verse.
I agree, so don't go to the 4.
Right.
Yeah.
Just make it a shorter reintro.
Yep.
Songwriting for me, it's kind of all about always being ready for the idea to come, because it's going to come to you, so you have to be ready to capture it. And that strikes when you least expect it, and then the daily work, which is the craft part of it, you know, you sit down with these ideas and you work on them.
When I was tracking Brandy's vocal, I decided that with the quality of her voice, that it might be better suited to a different preamp. She is going through an LTD-1 preamp by Chandler. I was able to dial in a really nice high frequency to bring out some of the breathiness in her voice. And the microphone I was using, Dave Royer used to sell these kits where you take an old Marshall MXL microphone, get rid of the guts. And he had, in an ammo box, he had all the parts. And her voice sounds beautiful through that. When you have an artist that's entrusted you not only with their music, their art, but their money, everything has to work. You don't have a lot of opportunities to redo a first take, so it's very important to me, and I've looked to Pro Tools to be able to just hit record. I'll use Pro Tools a lot, like tape.
You have to want to work all the time to really succeed at doing this career in any facet of the industry you're in. So I love the work ethic, and I think that's what drew me here. And that's a little bit of the difference. You know, Nashville is a little more business-based, and the hustle is a little bit more alive here, and I appreciate that.
There's a lot of aspects of the music that I make that would not be possible without Pro Tools. Without the power and flexibility of the software, the creativity inherent in being able to manipulate the most basic elements of sound. The last thing I want to be thinking about are any technical hindrances when I'm recording. I rely on Pro Tools to be transparent and to be reliable, and it is.